Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is a continuation of Christianity. So, Jesus was the younger Christ, and Nanak was the elder Christ. And both preached gospel according to the demand. Jesus preached gospel to the princes of darkness, baby. Judas Iscariot killed himself. And Christ, Nanak, preached gospel to the kings and emperors of darkness. They were very stubborn that Father himself has to come to kill them, to sort them up. So our Father looks after us. Our supernatural Father. So, here is I'm doing Holy Gospel of Jesus, the anointed Christ of living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., according to Saint Matthew 23, verse 1 to 12. Jesus spoke to the crowds and to the brethren. In Jesus we don't have disciples. The root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline natural men through the moral laws of Moses. Rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, they have the disciples. I used to call them disciple too, you know. And I had a friend, Fred Naylor, from Wigan, and he used to be a soldier. So I talked to him on telephone, and he said, "Mr. Niger, do you know the root of the word disciple?" I said, "No, it is discipline, as we discipline soldiers in army." So then I understood, you know, that in Jesus we don't have disciples because they are twice born, sensible laborers. Disciples are the natural boys, natural men who want to be disciplined through the moral of Moses. Not the once born disciples that the rabbis had. Rabbi had for disciplining in the moral laws of Moses, or by the letters. You know, you learn these laws are letters. People go to university to learn law, which is letters, saying the scribes and the Pharisees have taken their seat on the chair of Moses. Remember, Moses was the first prophet, and he put moral laws so that if you obey the moral laws, then you live in peace. You live in kingdom of heaven. Peace seen in law and order is of the kingdom of heaven. Against the royal kingdom, which is in our heart and which is a individual or of our own personal intrinsic. So this is the difference between the two kingdom, royal kingdom of God and of heaven is here and royal kingdom is here. Similar, you know. Sit on the seat of Moses. Therefore, do and observe all things whatsoever they tell you. That means 10 commandments. But do not follow their example. Now, of the 12 laborers of Jesus, Peter was once born. And he could not understand gospel. And once Jesus gave him a taste of gospel when he said, when Peter replied that you are the living Christ of living God, Then Jesus told him, unless our Father give you this gospel, you can't have it. That means natural man can't have it. So he became arrogant and started rebuking Jesus next. Then Jesus rebuked him. So, gospel is for the twice-born people, and the letters are for the once-born people. Peter went by what the rabbis told him. He was saying prayer, everything. Remember, Peter was carrying a sword, belt and sword. Whereas Jesus said, if somebody hit you on one cheek, present the other. He said, Darby, Darby, no. If somebody hit me, I will chop his head. But Jesus did not tell him not to do it. Because in Jesus, we have free will. We do whatever we like. And you have to give your own account to God. Jesus can't give your account. So, whatsoever, tell them, but do not follow their example. For they teach letters. Now, in the Bible, they put preach. The word preach is for gospel. I'm preaching gospel. I'm not teaching letters. Gospel comes from your heart. And when it's preached, when gospel you preach, it is from your heart and not from the book. That's why Jesus told his laborer, don't take money, two tunic, or scripture with you. Scripture means Bible with you. But they do not practice. They tie up heavy burdens, hard to carry. Ritual, you know, do this thing, do that thing. Now you have to bring an animal if you made a transgression against the law, letters or the law, they count it as sin. The greater the sin, the greater the fine they will impose on him. Sometime in India, you know, they will tell a poor man, go and bring a goat to be sacrificed. You have sinned against this one, so we need a goat. And the Brahman knows that he is cheating him. But they have no conscience, greed. That's why Christ come and set us free. And those who have conscience, they don't go by what Brahman says, they go by their inner man, the Christ. And lay them on people's shoulders, but they will not lift a finger to move them. They will put them heavier, you know, so that more obliged they are. All their works are performed to be seen by others, are for the extrinsic value. Extrinsic value means people see it, so that they could influence them, influence the general public. They widen their phylacteries and lengthen their tassels. They love places of honor at banquets, seats of honor in synagogues, and greetings in marketplaces, and the salutation, Rabbi. They used to be called them father also, you know. In the marketplace, they were standing their father. They will put on their garb, and people will ask them, hey, can you say prayer for me, please? Yes, no problem. Then he will say prayer, then he will say, give me money now. Longer the prayer, the more the money he will demand. So they had no conscience at all. Their conscience was dead. For the sake of money, they will tell all the lies. As for you, just the opposite. As we seek our intrinsic value, intrinsic inside our heart, value of our heart. We want our heart to be clean, not dirty. Hypocrite, We don't want to be hypocrites. And not the extrinsic praises of men. And do not be called rabbi or teachers that have slave disciples, such as Saul was of Gamaliel. He was slave to Gamaliel. His soul's conscience was saying what he is doing, in which he was torturing the laborers of Jesus. What he was doing is wrong. But to please his master Gamaliel, he was doing it. And this is what the Christ Thomas has, Saw Thomas said, you know, unless a female becomes a male, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. Now Saul, when he was doing, or the other disciples of the Pharisees, Sadducees, or any of them, you know, if you become the master, you also will have disciples. You will then join those rabbis, as these new rabbis, you find them in the churches, new hireling dog-collared priest, the rabbis in dog-collar. So they have slaves, you know, they will tell their congregation, do this thing, do that thing. They act like masters, as these rabbis used to do it. So they can't give their account to God. Everyone has to give his own account to God. So that's why Christ Thomas said, unless a female, that means who is dominated by another male, such as a rabbi or this dog-collar priest, so far he is under their domination, they are a female. Unless a female becomes a male, that may master of his own destiny, as in John 9, the born blind person was, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God, because it has narrow gate for the solitary. You need to be solitary to enter that narrow gate, and then graft yourself to the true vine that had been planted by our Father, God. As Saul was of Gamaliel, you have but one teacher, which is Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, we can call him inner man, Messiah. The Spirit of man, Holy Spirit is Spirit of man. Holy Spirit with capital S is the Spirit of God. So we go by the Spirit of God, that the Christ inside us will show us through logical reasoning. So the Holy Spirit, which is with small s, give you common sense, the Spirit of man. First you need to have Spirit of man, then if God be willing, he will give you his very Spirit, Holy Spirit with capital S, as the laborers of Jesus got it at Pentecost, when they were rewarded for their hard labor. In the evening, you know, the master of the vineyard come, he called the foreman, Christ Jesus, bring your laborers to be rewarded. And he paid them each one the same Holy Spirit with capital S. So that Spirit of capital S enabled you to read the hearts of people, as Peter did of the two liars, Ananias and Sapphira, and killed them on the spot. That is the power of the Holy Spirit. So that enabled you to think logically, to brew logos, the new wine logos, and you are all brothers. We have one Father, so we are brethren. Whether you are in flesh, you are a male or a female, because in Jesus, our supernatural self, soul counts, and not our natural self, this one, which has a masculine and feminine gender. That is why in Jesus there is neither Jew nor Gentile, nor male nor female. But we are all one, brethren, under our supernatural Father God, called Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Now the word Allah, these Mohammedans, they say Allah, Allah, but ask them, what is the origin of the word Allah? They have no idea. It is made up from Allah, the origin of Allah is Illah. Illah is the tribal father. You first need to be son of your tribal father, and then natural father. Then if God be willing, He will give you Holy Spirit to recognize our supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. So Allah is Al-Illah, the Father. Illah is the tribal Father. Then Allah, Al-Illah, the Father, which is supernatural Father, our God, Allah. So we call Him Parbrahm. Brahma is the Father of this one, Parbrahm of our souls. Same is Elohim, and call no one on earth your father. These, you know, as these Orthodox churches, you know, it's written there that nobody called, but they are very proud to be called father. If you don't call them father, they are not happy. There's a Catholic church next door to me, not far away, about 200 yards away. So I go there, and the priest told me that he is Father so-and-so, Gordon so-and-so. I said, I know two fathers. One, my natural father, where I got my Niger surname, and I know my supernatural father, God. I know these two fathers. What type of father you are? So when I asked them, I'm the custodian of the church here. I'm the custodian on behalf of the Christ Jesus. They don't know even to Christ. They call Him Jesus Christ. Jesus is the name. Christ is the title. So they put the title behind the name. Title should be put before the name. So even they don't know His name, and they become fathers. They are fake fathers. So I tell them, you are fake father. They get annoyed, but they can't kill me. So father, as these Orthodox and Catholic fake fathers are, you should also challenge them. You have but one supernatural father of our souls, and that He is called Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Inside you, because this is the temple of God. Temple of God. Where does God live then before the temple? Inside me, if I'm truthful and not hypocrite. If I'm a liar and hypocrite, then Father can't live there, because you represent our Father. So when you talk liar, our Father is not liar. Our Father is not hypocrite. He's like little child. What is inside is outside. So our Father is away, Satan is inside. When Satan is inside, then they don't know where God is. Then God is outside for them. So for me and my Father, we are one. And so was in Christ Jesus said, me and my Father is one. And so is me and my Father are one. So far you are truthful and not a hypocrite. So Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. inside you, the temples of God, if you are truthful and not hypocrites. Father in heaven used to be, Father in heaven, are of nature, you know, is Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, etc. So that used to be the outside, you know, in heaven. No, you know, Jesus said, every plant which my heavenly Father did not plant shall be uprooted. And that heavenly Father is Yahweh. That's why his name is Yeshua, made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua means Adam. Firstborn of Yahweh, second Adam. So anybody who, you know, break his covenant with Yahweh or the Brahma, the creator of male and female, he will be killed. And that's what's happening in the Middle East now. Christian, Muslim, and the Jews, and all these Hindu, Sikh, etc., they are not created by Brahma or by Yahweh. They are spiritual self, and the man-made names given to the people. They are not the Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian spiritual self. Spiritual self can't have children. Only our natural self can have children, and natural self is our tribal self. That's why Jesus, sitting in the temple, told the Jews, who were Jew outwardly of appearance, and John the Baptist called them brood of vipers. And Jesus told them that those people, especially of Judah tribe, from Judah tribe, because they were spiritual, they started Judaism. And from Judaism to Jew, and they became Jew outwardly. When they became Jew outwardly, tribal self, then the tribal Judah tribe thrown away. You can't have two tribes, only one. Either you have Judah tribe or Jew. If you become Jew outwardly, Judah tribe is out. And by its throwing that out, you become a bastard worse than those born of the prostitute. Or they are supernatural bastards, which ordinary man can't understand, unless he has the Holy Spirit. So that's why Jesus is sitting in the temple. You know, earlier they bring him a woman caught in adultery, which would have produced a natural bastard. But Jesus belonged to our supernatural Father, so his field was supernatural, not natural, but he had the domination over nature. That is why when he was writing down, he was writing down the sins of everyone who wanted to accuse her. When people came around and saw their own sins, they were surprised, you know, how the hell he knows our sins. So that's why Jesus went and told them, okay, the one who haven't sinned, let him throw the first stone. And they all run away. And the woman asked, she was apprehended, apprehensive. So she told me, nobody accused me. He said, I being belong to supernatural Father, I evaluate your heart and not this one. So if your heart is clean, you are good for me. And if your heart is dirty, then you are not good for me. Her heart was clean, and she appreciated what Jesus said and did. So she was set free of stoning. And Jesus went inside the temple to tell them, now I will tell you supernatural bastards. And that is how he told them, that your forefathers are devils. When he said that, he said your forefathers are super bastard fanatic devils. Not just devils. They, you know, in the Bible they softened it. And that's why they retorted, you know, we are not born of fornication. We have our parents, legitimate parents. Jesus said, what you say is true, but when you replace your tribal self with spiritual self, as people do, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, Jew, then they become super bastard fanatic devils, and that is what they are doing in the Middle East now, havoc. If they become sons of man, they can defeat them. Not these weapons are not going to defeat them. So you need to become son of man. Then these supernatural bastards have no power, no stand against you. That is the Hajarites, you know, that's why they do the Hajj rites, in which this type of Satan have the Aljmar, and people throw stone at them. So if they can repulse the Satan, you know, then when you become son of man, then you have the protection of your tribal father and of Yahweh, the one who created you. Nobody can touch you. Then you can enjoy crops as the chosen people were doing when they were faithful to Abraham and Yahweh. Yahweh planted them there. Yahweh brought them there in the Middle East to set up a demonstration nation of priests. And if you follow their history, you can understand the moral laws. If you do this thing will happen to you. Much more I have a book written, and you can get it over there. So do not call anyone a master. If you call him a master, then you become a slave. If like these, Saul was slave to Gamaliel, then you are no more master of your own destiny, but you have become a female. Unless a female becomes a male, she cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. Or unless a woman becomes a man, she can't enter into the royal kingdom of God. Anyone, a master, you have school teachers, or become slave disciples of any rabbi. Slave disciples of any rabbi, or the new rabbi, these dog-headed priests, or these fathers, you know, in the Orthodox Church, they put on robes and ask them what type of fathers they are. Are they my natural father or supernatural father? None of them, but they are thief. New rabbi. Pharisee, Sadducee, John the Baptist, etc., they had disciples. You have but one master, the inner man called Messiah. Inner man called Messiah, the Christ. That is why written over here, no Christ in your heart, no gospel, but dead letters. That is, no Christ in your heart, no gospel, but the dead letters of the scriptures. Those rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, etc., teach you. The greatest among you must be your servant. That is, in Jesus, we do not lord over people, because lords, they have slaves. Some people call Jesus a lord, which is wrong. Lords, they have slaves. As Pope did and killed people, but serve them as a servant does to his master. That is why Christ Paul advised the runaway slave to return back to his master, to serve him diligently, to prick his conscience. British ruled India, but there were very few whose conscience was pricked. You know, they are still, you know, when you meet them, they still think that we ruled India, and they still treat us as a slave, and they look down upon us. Very few, you know, who are the one who have conscience, they will give us equal right. Whoever exalts himself will be humbled, but whoever humbles himself will be exalted. That means you need to be humble in Christ Jesus. I hope I made this point clear. And gospel comes from your heart and not from the book. So unless you are a living in spirit, you have inner man in your heart. This is the temple of God. The one who is the priest of God is called royal priest or Christ. Unless you have Christ in your heart, you cannot have gospel. Christians have book knowledge, letters in their head. They are spiritually dead people. University professors, drunk with the old wine of the letters, I call them super donkeys carrying holy books, and they get annoyed with me. In Oxford, I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. They get annoyed. Then I ask them simple question. They can't answer. And they just look at me, you know, with their, what this man is saying things, you know, which nobody has said such daring things before to them. Our Father God blesses you.